As Ragin King continues his battle to survive a gun attack, our stage this week presents an update on his condition, as well as a one-on-one chat we had done with the Montagonian upon his arrival in dancehall that traces his explosive rise. A former Magnum Queen's triumphant transition from contestant to recording star via social media. The artist has one of the hottest songs in dancehall at the moment and comes to share her story of struggles and triumph. And coming to a screen near you this fall. Yes, it's the long-awaited Dancehall Divas reality show. The show's creator, Heather Elliott, brings to our stage four of the divas. This week's top 10 trending songs and more are all coming up. Welcome to the show, everyone. I am Winford Williams. We'll be back.
Internationally acclaimed On Stage with Winford Williams.
Download our app and be on our stage anywhere, everywhere, always.
So much more than entertainment.
And we're back now with our top 10 trending songs in Jamaica, according to YouTube.
Switching things up a bit this week to include every genre of music that is trending in Jamaica. And coming in at number 10, a guest on our show this week, Chenille Muir, with her breakout single, Yamabella.
Talent over high. Me not spend me rent in a no party. And now buy Patron if my don't have a pot. Right now, me deep when I say 40.
And coming in at number 9, Doja Cat featuring Gucci Mane with Like That.
You know, I hate it when I'm left on red. But it make it all up in the bed. And it's
Intense is Through the Gate this week at number 8.
Even if we had the set size, my same shows. Any same and a drink and Grey Ghost. Them I go need wings to catch you get a Red Bull.
While Da Baby is a rock star at number 7.
Pull it out, shoot. PTSD. I'm always waking up a cold sweat like I got the flu. My daughter is G.
Well known for his surprise projects, from his new body of work, Vent, Dexter Dapps is Heartless at number 6.
She's like fire.
Starting off our top 5, Popcorn speaks of friends like these.
Friends like these, who need enemy? Who needs enemy?
And Squash is Skillful at number 4.
Understand that we give and them still while we feed them. You're right.
Do this by myself and we don't need nobody else.
Chronic Law sees Dark Clouds at number 3.
We just a holy thought. Yeah, me ring a fire and the prayer them I go up in a mommy church.
While from his new Dons and Divas album, Vibes Cartel featuring his son Little Vibes and Squash are number 2 with Jump on the Beat.
Jump on the beat and beat it like it's Ota Ada. Adi, 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 fiddy, pull them boy.
And for the 3rd week in a row, the number 1 trending artist is Intense, but this week with a new entry called Wanda. A bitter feud spanning 10 years. Spice and Lisa Hypa had been enemies for almost as long as their careers in dancehall. On Thursday, though, that feud was no more. In a sort of tell-all Instagram post and in a Star article, Lisa Hypa said sorry and formally put the past behind her. Spice, in turn, posted Lisa's apology on her Instagram page with the message "Apology accepted" and offered apologies of her own. Fans and supporters of both the ladies were ecstatic and made their voices heard in the comments. Who's next to bury the hatchet? Stay tuned to On Stage.
As many of you know, dancehall artist Ragin King is a victim of gun violence in Jamaica that took place earlier this week that left a member of his entourage dead and the artist severely injured. Joining us right now, right here on our stage for an update on the artist's condition is producer Dwayne Parkinson, a.k.a. Damage music. Damn it, sir.
Blessed, Mr. Winford.
Yeah,
man. How you doing, sir?
Blessed love and thanks for coming through and
yeah, man,
wanting to do this for us.
Yes, Mr. Winford, because you know it's a sad thing, you know. We could have lost a great reggae star, dancehall star, same, you know.
Yes. So what can you tell us about the incident, though?
As far as details concerning the whole incident, I'm not quite clear. But as for the artist, I did get an update that he had a successful surgery. And, you know, he's in observation room recovering now. And as you know, the management had issued privacy in regard to, you know, certain details surrounding okay. the artist.
Understandable. So the official situation as it relates to his condition, he's done a successful surgery.
Yes, he has done a successful surgery, and the doctors are saying is that he's improving. So, you know, we have been praying, you know, sending more prayers for his speedy recovery right now.
Okay, so can you say when he'll be able to leave the hospital?
Well, that is not, we're not clear yet because I didn't get so much of information. Mm-hmm. But I do hope it's pretty soon, you know.
And have you been able to speak to him?
No, I haven't been able to speak to him. I went by the hospital on Sunday just to be able to make sure that, and you know, there was a lot of people outside the hospital.
Okay.
Because, you know, it was just last month we did a huge track, you know, video yes. and song we released, a recent new music. So, you know, it was pretty shocking to hear that.
And his family, how are they feeling? How are they taking this?
Well, I haven't spoken to members of his family, but I know they're wondering as to how he's recovering. Mm-hmm. And as you say, we do hope and pray that everything is going right, you know?
Okay.
Because as details surrounding the artist right now, in observation, the doctors are not giving much information as to the process or anything. You know, we don't know the details of what fully happened, but we just want to make sure that he makes a speedy recovery and he's back on his feet.
Yes. Well, my friend, we're wishing the same, and we look forward to him coming back. Thank you so much for coming and giving us, to give us this
yeah,
update, my friend. And I want to tell all our viewers right now that later on, we will play for them the story of Ragin King's explosive rise in dancehall. That's coming
yes.
up later. And also coming up right here on stage, Chenille Muir. That's a name you need to remember and an interview you need to watch. But first, Dancehall Divas will be right here on our stage. You don't want to miss that either.
The internationally acclaimed On Stage with Winfred Williams.
Download our app and be on our stage anywhere, everywhere, always.
So much more than entertainment.
Dancehall Divas is the name of a new reality TV show that highlights the intriguing dancehall subculture. The show is set to be riddled with drama, affluence, and swag. On our stage right now, Dancehall Divas creator, executive producer, Heather Whitehead, and four of the Dancehall Divas, Juicy Bunny, Sky Hollywood, Sima, and Daniel D.I., all on our stage right now. Ladies, welcome.
Thank you.
Hey.
Okay, so you guys are all over the world right now.
But yeah.
I'm going to go with you first. Heather, the creator of this show, could you just give us a quick summary of your background and the inspiration behind this dancehall project?
Sure. First of all, thank you, Winfred, for having us. And you know what? I've always wanted to say this, and I have to say it here, that I've watched your show grow into this global entertainment phenomenon over the years.
Yes.
And I know hard it, you know what it takes and how hard it was to do that. So I have to congratulate you. Well done. And thanks for having us. So a little bit about my background. I am a public relations executive. I have a PR firm in the United States. I've also worked in the C-suite and corporate for a number of years. But now I am a proud producer of the world's first dancehall reality show. And I'm so excited about that. And, just to sort of highlight the show a little bit, if a few persons were asking, oh, what is a dancehall diva? Or what is the show about? Again, like I said, I'm just so proud that we have created what we believe is the world's first dancehall lifestyle series. And what this does is, what this is rather, it features the lives of six women from the four most populous dancehall cities. So we have New York, we have Toronto, we have London, and of course we have Kingston, Jamaica. And the show will follow their lives, their interactions, how they're interconnected through music, through entertainment, through the lifestyle, through the subculture itself. And basically we will watch them as they bond or break, we'll see their ups and downs. And of course there is a lot of drama, as you're going to see in the trailer. But it was very important for me to get women who were already connected from different, of the dancehall cities across the world.
So you yourself, you're a dancehall fan?
I am. And you know what? I grew up in the country, in Trelawney, Seventh-day Adventist to the core. I still worship on a Sabbath.
Really?
Don't kill me. I'm a bad Adventist. But, I was introduced to dancehall by my Canadian friend years ago. I went to Canada. I was 16 years old. And, I love it. You know what I mean? I'm conservative, but I'm about the business of dancehall. I think it's indigenous to who we are as a people, as a culture. And I saw the opportunity, and here we are. The rest is history.
Wow. So before we go to the ladies, the divas, let's just take a look at the trailer right here.
In the world of dancehall, there is music, the vibes, the culture, and then there is the lifestyle. Six women, six different personalities, unlimited drama, unlimited swag, one purpose: dancehall divas.
We should record together.
Yeah,
because Peppa, I know you're trying to be an artist and everything, so I think
that's really bad.
When I saw that bitch giving me the side eye and cutting her eye, like, I would want any permanent. Never in life. You understand? When she's looking at me like that, I'm telling you, I want to beat that. I wanted to kick her off that ball and just like start stamping in her face.
And I just want to say thank you guys for a wonderful time in Toronto. I'm having an amazing time. As you know, it's my first time here.
Yes, baby.
Can you touch you? Excuse me for a second.
Never give up.
All right, so already we are seeing who bad. Yeah. Okay, all right. So, yeah, you're a recording diva, a recording star with perhaps more credentials in music than any of the others. Who are you playing? Daniel or the bad girl, Diai? Who is she?
Yeah. I'm just being me, but I'm really happy to be a part of this project. I know it's going to be huge in the diasporas. I know the world is going to love it like they love any one of the reality shows that we watch on the big network. And I know that we have potential to be on air a good, nice 10, 15 years. So, as an entertainer, it's a different avenue for me. Carlene, the dancehall queen, introduced me to Heather, and when Heather told me her vision, I'm like, why not? It's a different avenue for me to entertain and for me to get out there to my fans and meet new fans. So I'm all about it, and I know the world is definitely going to be tuned to this. It's great entertainment, Winnie. You're going to love it. You're going to watch it every week.
Well, okay. All right. I'll be free. I'll be available, okay, to watch. Simon, you're an instructor. You're a trainer, a fitness trainer.
I previously done some gym work and some gym instructing. Yeah, amongst other things.
Yes, some other things such as.
Yeah. So basically, apart from being a part of Dancehall Divas, I'm also a recording artist in the UK.
Yes.
Music I do is Jamaican influence, but with a bit of UK flavour. So, yeah, you're going to hear a lot of my style, a lot of the influence from Jamaica, as my parents are Jamaican descendant. And Dancehall Divas and the journey, and I'm ready to bring it and show the world dancehall lifestyle.
Okay, and the real deal, right?
The real deal.
will be as real as you are.
Yes.
Okay. How popular is dancehall lifestyle?
Well, in the UK?
In the UK, yes.
Major, big. And this is the thing, I want to show the world like how dancehall has a big influence in the whole world, including the UK, you know, and the United States and everywhere else. It's a big thing, and we're ready to be the first people to represent, you know, in a reality show. So, yeah, looking forward to it.
Okay, so Juicy, where's Juicy now? Let's hear from you, Juicy. Talk a little bit about your role in this and how you feel about being part of it.
I'm really excited and grateful to be a part of the Divas. Heather's, her passion for what we're doing, I feel like is just, it's impeccable. And I think the world deserves to see that there's more to dancehall than what they perceived in the past. We always thought of dancehall as being this rugged thing.
Yes.
And I want people to understand that there's more to it. And Heather has this vision and we're all on board with it.
And you're a rapper, aren't you?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. So I'm an up and coming rapper and an actress. So I can't wait. You guys are going to be hearing some of my music too.
All right, Sky. So Sky, you are where exactly? Where are you based?
I'm in New York.
Okay. And all right, so your own background and how do you feel about this?
Well, I'm from Kingstown, Port Morris, Gaza. Yes, and I'm super excited. Heather, I love you and I thank you for this opportunity. So the producer reached out to me and it was history because I'm dancehall.
Yes.
Dancehall is Sky. So to get this opportunity, it's amazing. And I can't wait for the world to see and for Dancehall Divas to be also named.
Yeah, yeah. So camera, you weren't shy of the camera to be on camera for the world to see you in all your dancehall glory?
Yes, I was a little bit shy, even though social media, I'm a big influencer over there. And being on camera, I get bubbly nervous, but I got this, Winfred. I got this.
Yeah. So you're pleased with what you've done so far in the series, right?
To be honest, I was shocked seeing myself. I was like, that's Sky. I can't believe, but it's amazing. It's amazing being on Dancehall Divas or in Dancehall Divas. It's super amazing. I can't believe like I actually got this opportunity.
So, and you're a business owner. What business are you in? What's your business?
I'm a business owner. I'm a microdermabrasion practitioner, which is skincare. I do skincare, and I have my own skincare line as well.
Nice. So, Heather, what you're bringing out now, you know, is that dancehall is very, very diverse. It's a diverse genre of music. Though sometimes we believe we have a stereotypical view of dancehall and its exponents.
Absolutely. And that was really the premise of the show. I mean, again, everybody who knows me knows that I'm just very conservative, very bougie type person. But I am in love with the culture of dancehall. And like I said, you know, I saw the business opportunity and I wanted to tell their stories. A lot of the times, this is an international dancehall show, so it was really important for people to see what dancehall is like abroad. You know, not just when you click on YouTube or click on social media and the girl is, you know, gyrating up the crotch on the concrete and all of that. This is not what this is about. Because people think that when you hear dancehall, it's either derogatory if it's not related to their favorite dancehall art. And so this is going to show the lifestyle, which is the most important component of the show. And people are going to see the exuberance, the fanfare that surrounds these women. And the interesting thing about the show is that within the cast, we have promoters, we have entertainers, we have social media influencers, we have public figures, and the show is going to show how they all connect to create the business of entertainment and the subculture. But the thing is, we were actually in the middle of shooting. So we had just come back from Toronto when the pandemic hit in March, and we were on our way to the UK, and we had to put a stop in there. And so similar to the larger productions, what they have done is say, you know what? We can't keep the world waiting too much longer. We're just going to put out what we have. And so we have fewer episodes than we had anticipated, but it was the right time to put it out. So come September, they'll be able to see the show on CNTV, Amazon Prime, and on our website, our streaming. And it's, we have a number of episodes. They should look forward, of course, to the live reunion. Mm-hmm. It's going to be something special.
Okay, so your locations.
Most of it is shot in Canada. That's where my production company is located, and that's where my production team is. But we do get to travel. And as again, we were just about to literally board the plane to London when all of this hit.
So will Jamaica be on that list of locations?
Absolutely. Absolutely. It's a must.
Yes, because we've been hearing about it for a long time.
Yeah, and have been
anticipating its coming to Jamaica.
I know.
So that's it, ladies. Thank you so much for coming and sharing
Thank
all of
you.
This with us. All right, so there you have them, the Dancehall Divas, coming to a screen near you in September. All right, stay with us right here on stage, still to come. If I never the inspirational story of Shanelle Muir. And later, Reagan King's explosive rise in dancehall. We'll be back.
The internationally acclaimed On Stage with Winfred Williams.
Download our app and be on our stage anywhere, everywhere, always.
So much more than entertainment.
A former Magnum Queen's triumphant transition from contestant to recording star via social media is worth celebrating. The artist has one of the hottest songs in dancehall at the moment and comes to our stage right now to share her story. Her name is Shanelle Muir. Right now, right here on our stage, joining us from Florida. Hey, Shanelle, welcome.
Hi, thank you, Winfred. Thank you so much for having me on stage. It's a pleasure.
Great to have you. And are you okay in Florida?
Yes, I am fine. I'm safe staying inside.
So last week we had you on our countdown, right? Our dancehall trending countdown.
Yes.
And we say that, you're an unknown artist who came from nowhere and burning up the chart. I'm just paraphrasing here. And then we were trolled by your following. Now, how dare you say she's unknown? She's the biggest thing. and so we had to back off of that. And we apologize. Let me say that now to all of them. It was not intended to insult or to make her small. And we were looking forward to when we meet her right here on our stage. And that, I suspect, you could say was expedited, the meeting. So here we are. Here we are now with her, our guest right here on stage. Again, welcome, Shanelle. Tell your fans them for back off now. We're and them are friends now. They are our fans now, so we're just one big family, okay? Okay. So your story is one of inspiration, in my view, because we know that it's a big challenge to transition from a contest where you will get very popular and get a lot of people knowing you. You're in fact a star, but the bar is higher now for you to be a recording artist, but you get the all-important bus and you're out now. Would you consider this record your breakout?
Honestly, I do consider Yama Bella my breakout record.
Okay. Because all right, say no more, because some of our viewers may not have heard it before. So let's go to a little piece of the song right here.
Talk, girl. I'm never born in a last week. Me still shop at DDs. I'm still shop at Macy's. Not got certain places. Me a girl, me no frightened for link. I'm no frightened for face. Young girl, no for killing. If I know your size, don't wear it. And if I know your price, don't claim it. You better buy what your money can buy. Put some in your savings. Woman, fi have confidence. And you feel learn fi depend for yourself. Do your little 9 to 5, me darling. But like your check on Friday morning. Somehow no don't use conscience. Rather buy here before you buy bed. Cock up in a man care before you. Put your kids before you. Big stink in your mid. What a good thing, me no live fi impress people.
Alright, so that's the big breakout song. So speak to us now about your journey from the contest to this song.
With Magnum Kings and Queens, I entered into this competition in 2016. There were a lot of contestants. I had confidence in my music then, but you know, at least I needed a little push here and there from family members, friends, everybody who knew what the talent I had. I wanted to learn basically what it's like to really get out there with my music, to perform live for a live audience. I wanted to be critiqued. Because I felt that in order for me to move forward and to move where I wanted to be, I needed to take a step that is going to build me for what I'm aiming for.
So you had no exposure before the contest?
Not really.
Okay.
Not really.
And where did you end up in the contest?
I actually dropped out of the contest in the top 10. Actually, okay. You know, have 5 males, 5 females. So I was one of the top 5 females there. Mm-hmm.
Where did you get back the confidence to move forward? And what point, when, how long after?
It was a very good while after. It was about 2018, where, because a lot of things happened between that time, Winford. My timeline is a roller coaster.
Okay.
My life has fluctuated in many ways. I've been blessed with so many things, and yet I've lost so much between that specific time, you know, and when I picked myself up. Because even after that, there are so many deaths that surrounded my whole life, my whole phase that I've been going through.
Oh,
I actually migrated to the US after I left Jamaica. I left Jamaica 2016, that same year. So by the time I was eliminated from the competition earlier on in the year, there and then I did a production, a record with Good Good Production called Proud Side Chick, which was when people started to listen a lot more than before that. I migrated to the US, to California, to live with my family there. In 2018, after that, will be 2 years afterwards. I didn't do music between 2016 and 2018 because migrating, I was, you know, came overseas, I was working, I was going back to school, doing 2 jobs actually, working as a cashier at a discount store called BD's, if anybody's familiar with that in the US. And after, in 2018, Winfred, I lost 2 uncles in 2 weeks. My grandparents lost their house in that specific time as well, in the month of April. And my family was taken aback.
Oh.
Almost lost hope. I wasn't interested in doing music, and I had turned my life over in a spiritual term. I just needed that inner peace, that inner comfort. I didn't give up on music completely. I still had a little piece of hope left, a little piece of faith left to push me forward, but I needed to get through that phase. I needed to understand what I wanted in life, and I needed to know where I was going from there.
All of that trial and tribulation and stress and many jobs and migration and reset and disruption in your life. And so this song, this breakout song, fill in the blanks for me between that time and the song.
I doing music as an artist, as a female artist to be specific, it's always a cliche on how a lot of people have it seeming as if a female cannot come out on top without singing certain kind of songs. However, I wanted to utilize my writing skills. I use my drive. for my with my ambition and my talent itself and that passion that I have for music and to the urge to be something, to be someone, mm-hmm. and to remain consistent, not just to get the fame and to get the exposure, but also to stand firm and have that grip. My inspiration came from all the things that I've been through.
Okay.
And knowing that the other people are going through a lot more, but they still keep pushing forward. So my drive comes from wanting to be that person.
Sounds like you garnered inspiration from all the tribulation.
All my struggles, everything has inspired me. It's not just one thing, because I still learn going forward. I still move forward. Even yesterday, I lost another family member, which is very unfortunate. So just to show you, like, my journey doesn't stop. And I don't think my journey stops here either. It's just the start. But my goal when I wrote this song was to even reach out to females who think that they have to have a certain standard in a sense of buying certain things or looking a certain way to please other people. A lot of times I see women that actually work hard for what they have get left out of the music industry. And it's just true because, you know, the brands are always the high topic, the high stuff, the nice car and all those things. But I wanted to be that person to remind these females and even males themselves mm-hmm. that, you know, you don't have to leave it to impress anybody, because at the end of the day, if you work hard for something and that's yours, you should be proud of it.
Okay. So you wanted to go against the grain, so to speak.
Yes.
You know, there's the lane of explicit sexual.
Because I do that music as well, Linford.
No, I'm not
do.
Saying you don't. I'm just saying that you took pen to put pen to paper to do this yes. record, and you were doing what is not the norm. You know, like some, how confident were you when you were writing this song? Were you writing for a bus or writing for your own, recording your art, your feeling, what you were feeling at the time? Yeah.
I was writing because that's my passion and that's my love. And I was writing to reach out to people.
Yes.
I didn't know what would bust. Because honestly, when I wrote 3D, which is an explicit song, I thought that song would have, you know, every song that I write, I want to put my all into it. I want it to be a bus song. If
yes.
you get
okay.
what I
mean. So that is always present. Okay.
Yeah, that is always something that I drive, I push for. But when I wrote Yamabella, I was like, you know what? I'm writing this. If it reach, it reach, but I want the message to be taught as well.
Okay. So Yamabella, explain the name for us.
I would say it comes from the word yamhead, because, you know, they use that term for females who tend to be submissive to men, even if it means that they'll be putting themselves in certain positions. Mm-hmm. But I wanted to use the Yamabella term in a sense where it broadens the horizon on what a yamhead is.
Yes. So, okay, cool.
So, you know, so it doesn't have to do with being in a relationship. It has to be prioritizing things like females that go out of their way to look a certain way, to dress a certain way, to for the hype of it, instead of living in their means and living by how their budget should allow them to do it, you know.
Okay. And so where are you now in terms of your follow-up and what else bubbling in your catalog?
Okay, so there is a lot of music. I would classify myself as a versatile artist. I don't just sing dancehall music. I am capable of singing reggae. I rap. When I write music, I don't just write just to rhyme words. You know, I write with substance. I want to send messages, whether it's to tell a man that, you know, you're too good enough for a woman, or whether it's to tell a girl that, you know, you need to be ambitious, or to tell the children in school, stay in school. You know what I mean? Like, I like to write stories in my music.
Is it now that you've gotten the breakout, is it dragging through the others? Others that you had done and been sitting on? Or
yes.
Nobody no pee no mind? Are you getting, are they
no mind.
Checking out your catalog?
Yes, they have been. In fact, I did this song called Pretty Pink with a little video. It's one of the explicit songs. However, when I just released that video, it probably got like 30,000 to 40,000 views in maybe 6 to 8 months. And over the past few weeks after I released Yamabella, that spiked to 300 and something thousand views.
Oh.
And that's authentic views, Winford. That's authentic people clicking on the video and watching that video. You understand?
Okay, so we weren't questioning it, okay? We would never do that. We weren't questioning.
So social media is your main vehicle in the transition from contestant to recording star. How did you do it?
You know, when I moved to Florida, I decided, you know, so I'm gonna stop the music. Because me, honestly, me, I say, sure, nobody now pay me no mind. More when I see something, I get the highlight. When me, I say, boy, I'm there, so they do good music, and then I get no attention. But me, I say, you know what? Let me stop for a second. March 15, my work called me. Because I just moved here, basically just spending savings and stuff like that to situate myself. And then I just got a job. Get a call, say, you know, you're going to have to stay home because Corona and all of this. I'm like, oh my goodness, I just moved here. Like, why am I feel like my life I moved backwards? But then at the time, because I was working night shifts, I was going to work 10:30 p.m., getting off at 7:30 in the mornings, sleeping all day, doing the same thing over and over again. I felt like I didn't have time for myself. So when actually I got the break, I was like, you know what, probably this is time for me to rest. Then maybe a week going on me, I said, boy, I can't rest when I have so much that I want to accomplish. So forget this Corona thing. May I go find a way for people to listen? Because maybe this is an opportunity for me to actually reach out to people besides the Corona. So you know what? I utilized my platform at the time. I was probably around 30-something thousand followers on Instagram. When I went live the first time, I can remember specifically, I probably had about 45 people consistently watching the live. And seeing how I perform now on my live shows on my Instagram page at Chanel Muir is the same way I perform to the 1,300 people that are now watching consistently. So I decided when the Corona and everything happened now, you know what, me I go do this. You know, because I was traveling back and forth. That's how me, actually last year when I did the single Vex Win featuring Stylo G, I actually reached out to Papi Don because Papi Don wasn't really doing music at the time either. Mm-hmm. And I was like, Papi, you need to send me some rhythm, man. You can't. It'll send me one rhythm one time. And, you know, do you understand? We need to do some work. And he's like, you know, it's true. And the funny thing is we have such a chemistry with music. Right now, I am currently signed. I just did a signing with Good Good Productions. Mm-hmm. I will also be working with Papa Don Music. You know, we started out with a very good chemistry. So we'll always be working together as well. And he's happy for me. So, you know, that means a lot because, you know, the thing is, a lot of times when we start off with a person, we don't end up working further with that person. Mm. But it doesn't mean you leave them off for the whole thing, you know? So Papa Don, I want to big up Papa Don Music 100%, you know, and we'll always be doing music as well. So there's a lot to look out for Good Good Production and Chanel Muir. And I also have a song coming out with Shot Boss Music. So, you know, there's a lot of things that are going to happen. I also have songs that I know my people want to hear more from me. And all they have to do is continue supporting and continue providing what they want to hear. And I have so many fans that show me so much love. You hear me keep on repeating because the love that they show me, it makes me emotional sometimes, most of the time, because honestly, to get that authentic love, it means so much more than, you know, it overshowed the hate. Because hate I go always there, but that love that my people show me, that support that they give to me, sending me trending number up to number 5 number on YouTube, and, you know, being able for on stage to find my music, because without them, that would not have happened.
Well, don't overcredit us, but I mean, we're here, Spider. That's why we're here.
You know, what? But I'm grateful for this, Winfred, and I want you to know that, and I really do. We accept your apology because, you know, before we even leave that, because when we heard it, because they've been with me for so long, you know, for me to be, maybe it was a wrong choice of words, obviously, but I appreciate you taking the time to have me here on your show, because this is a show I've been watching since I was a small child.
It was easy. It was very easy to do, because you're, you know, it's a great story of inspiration, of struggles, and of winning, of triumph. So you're special, and you should remain that way. And going forward, I don't think anything can stop you, you know. Based on what you go through already as, and being so young, I don't know what can stop you in life, my girl. So just stay the course and keep the music coming. Yes. And we'll be watching.
Yes.
And reporting.
Yes.
All right.
But I want to say, Jason, it's okay. You know, we love you. The top girl them, and you know, everybody that supports Chenille. Okay. You know, it was just a little mess.
All right. All right, Chenille. Chenille Muir is the name, everybody, just in case you put it in your head. Definitely going places in music. All right, so stay with us right here on stage.
Sweet God, no complaints tonight.
The explosive rise in dancehall of Ragged King.
The internationally acclaimed On Stage with Winfred Williams.
Download our app and be on our stage anywhere, everywhere, always.
So much more than entertainment.
As Ragged King continues his battle to survive a gun attack, our stage this week presents the one-on-one chat we had done with the Montagonian upon his arrival in dancehall that traces his explosive rise. Out of the troubled second city, Montego Bay, comes an artist whose impact has taken his voice and message out of that city and into the ears of dancehall fans everywhere. Some declared him the hottest new arrival in dancehall. Whoa, whoa, whoa. But who is he really? Well, you may know him as Ragged King. Right now, right here on our stage. Ragged.
Yeah, man,
blessed love, sir. Yeah, man, welcome. First of all, explain your name for me.
You don't know Ragged King, forward from an element of the ghetto, you understand?
Yes.
Being myself, you understand? Yeah, and you don't know, it was a well-known criminal back in the days.
His name was Ragged.
Yes.
And that's who, so you took your name from him?
Yeah, because I'm a rebel. He's a rebel. He stand up for himself. Being a rebel is just standing up for yourself and what you really want and what you really love and what you really like. So that's where the name inspires from.
So what drove you to want to stand up for yourself at such a young age? Because you started music, when did you call yourself this?
Well, I've been calling myself Ragged about from 2012.
Okay.
Before I was Jabi.
Yes.
Yeah, people them know me as Jabi doing music. Because I've been doing music from 10
At that time,
age.
You were a teenager?
Yeah.
How old were you?
At that time, let's say, I was about 15, 14.
15 thereabout?
Yeah.
And you wanted to be Ragged, the man who thought he could fly? Okay.
Yeah.
And he could, that he was indispensable and all that, whatever else. I don't remember the full story. But so was it circumstances in your life, in your community that caused you to want to take on that persona, that name, and so on?
Not really. It's just that, you know, everybody have followed with something new up on the table.
Yes.
You understand, you have to just try to see if you can fit in, you know, that slot. You don't really, might have to fit in, just do something outstanding, different from the rest. So that was just me being myself. So me just bring forward the name from someone else, or from the culture.
From the culture.
From
Absolutely.
The culture.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, yeah, so it's a name, but it's an infamous person.
Yeah,
why not
yeah.
a person who wasn't so controversial?
As
Marcus Garvey.
Well, as me say, me couldn't say Marcus Garvey, but it still follow up on the dominance, being yourself as a rebel and going, looking forward for what you really want as yourself.
And so, to you, rebel means what? Rebelling against the system?
Not rebelling against the system. Mm. Rebelling against whatsoever you might get a fight for. You
okay.
understand? Yeah, you're standing up for your rights. I'm doing dancehall music and I have to prove to the people them, say, Aminium One King, Dancehall Body Sting. You understand? Reggae King. You understand?
Reggae King. Yeah. Dancehall
Body Sting. That's my slogan.
Body Sting.
Yeah, man. That's it. Yeah, man.
Body Sting.
Yeah, man.
Okay.
Everybody, I say one thing, you know, and I one king, you know.
Yes.
Yeah, man. So, yeah, if you understand, say, I just that right now.
No, we commend you, you know, because yeah. We want to get to where we commend you for your work so far. Yeah. But I wanted to see why you call yourself that. And Montego Bay, we haven't seen a star rising as fast as you are rising.
True.
From the second city in a while. So again, that's a big prop for the second city, which as you know, is very troubled at the moment. Let's go to one of your videos right now. It's a new video that we have queued up for you. Let's give the viewers who haven't heard you yet a chance to listen to your music right now. Let's go to it.
Me remember all me grow, so me know me I go.
All right, that's the title, How Me Grow, Rigging King. Sir, so that song is your lyrics? Those are your lyrics?
Yes, man, I don't know my lyrics, them, the man. How me grow, so how could it not be my lyrics? That's what's just how me grow.
Yes, it's articulating how you grow.
Yeah.
And so you're the writer of the song?
Yeah, I'm writing all of my songs.
All your songs all are yours? Songs.
All of my songs are mine.
Are they describing your life always like this one?
Yeah.
Are they all describing how you live and what you're seeing?
That's me.
And
that's
feeling
me.
In the moment?
That's the person.
Reality?
That, yes, that's the person that I am, you know? You get to feel or know Reggae King in my music.
Yes.
I don't have to be here. But just listening to my music, you know how I grow. I say how I grow, I say things all change. I say more them teach me learn, I say paranoid. Mm-hmm. And it's a variety of how I grow, and it's a variety of what I'm doing and how I live.
Same.
Yeah, so you guys can relate.
So how do you describe your music?
Well, I'm describing my music different from the rest, you know? Mm-hmm. I'm doing dancehall trap music, you understand? I'm bringing the trap here.
Trap music?
Yeah. It's American style. Yeah, so.
Okay.
Them with them say, yeah, don't panic, South Compton, all of them side. Don't know what brings that energy there in a dance hall. You understand? The younger generation, man. You understand? We are trapped. That's why I say, my paranoid with that flow there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. One king, man. Me alone.
why is that so important to you? One king?
Yeah.
One king means what? Because there's a dance hall king and the king is relevant to dance hall?
Yeah, big up the king himself. Yeah, but me have to say something.
So you recognize that Beanie is the king?
Beanie man.
Yes.
Big up Beanie man. You understand?
So,
Reggae King is Reggae King, that's my name. And I got to be a king for my people. I'm king of my city right now.
Okay.
And I got to,
well, I agree.
Yeah.
At the moment.
Yeah. I'm the king of my city and yeah. I gotta show the people them some ready. I have to prove to them some ready. You understand? For be the king.
Okay, so let's talk a little bit about now your background in Montego Bay. You've articulated a lot of it in your song. But can you talk a little bit more about your family and what community in Mobay you're from?
Yeah, you don't know one king from the whole part of West, because I was born in a Westmoreland.
Okay.
But eventually, I lived in a Montego Bay when I was about 2 years old, so you don't know. Mm-hmm. Big up the whole of Westmoreland people, them have my back full support, said we.
Same.
Yeah, and I moved from Burn Savannah, and me reaching a flanker, Mobay. You understand? Yeah. Flank and place. You understand? The people them support me, them love me. And you don't know. It's a good place to be. Like anybody who didn't recommend.
Even now.
Even now. And anybody who didn't recommend them places is a good place to be. Because them depicting that a lot of arrogance are going on and a lot of things are going on. But you don't know. People have to go out and do what they have to do in the meanwhile. You have to work, you understand? Me have to do my artist business, and the fans, they have to cheer and say one king, you understand?
So people are still living in Montego Bay.
Yes, everybody is living. Yeah, that's
the
moral.
They're not scared of doing what they normally do. People are living their life, going about their business as usual.
Yes. People are living their life good, man, and them thing there. That's why me there on this interview right now, because people met me there at us right now.
All right, we're going to talk a little bit. I'm going to give you a chance to talk a little bit more about the situation as it relates to violence in Montego Bay. But go back to your family. What size family?
Yeah,
and
you don't
who
know.
Who are some of your siblings, mother, father?
Yeah, you don't know. Family big, you know. You don't know. Big up my father. You don't know. My mother migrated foreign from when I was about 6 years old.
Same.
Yeah. You don't know. I grew up with my father. my brother and my sister, them, my stepmother, yeah.
How many brothers and sisters?
Yeah, you don't know, me have about 7 brothers and sisters, yeah, at the time. So, just I big up everybody and just make
and they're all good?
Yeah, everybody good. Everybody good and everybody support the music.
And support
everybody's
you.
Supportive and...
Mommy and daddy yeah, are supporting
everybody
you
is supportive at the moment. And right now, you don't know, the breadwinner for the family, so...
And school, where did you go to school and how far did you go?
I attend Irwin High, Flankers Primary and Junior High. Mm-hmm. You don't know. Some little things did go on when I did fall out of school from grade 10, but that never did stop certain things for me because I was always go-getting, you understand?
And you don't want to say what caused them to expel you from school?
I think I don't really want to disclose, but you don't know. Youth and youth always have fiction, you yes, understand? But that makes me a better man at this time right now,
yes,
from where I'm standing.
So do
up
you
myself.
Go seeking knowledge? To inform yourself about
of
things.
Of course, that's
you
that's,
read a lot.
Yes.
Okay.
That's one of my main hobbies. I read a lot, you know. And my team always I make sure I know new things.
Yes.
You understand? And I wasn't a dumb kid at school. I was a bright kid as always. You know, it didn't have any disadvantage on me. The only thing that I don't have a subject.
Okay.
But I don't have a disadvantage.
It makes you better off?
No, I didn't say it makes me better off. I said I don't have a disadvantage.
But do you regret it?
I regret that I didn't finish school at the time.
But do you regret whatever caused it? Whatever
of
you
course,
did to cause it?
Of course. Because okay, I'm a big man now. Mm. And seeing what I did was wrong.
Yes.
Yeah, so you don't know. We are move on and now. The more them teach me learn. I'm going to sing that song there. So I'm going to live the song.
Okay, so where are you going in music? Where do you want to go? And talk a little bit more about the difference you make in the space. What are you doing different from the rest right now? Why are you getting so much love and so much attention right now? Why? Put it all together for me, from your perspective.
Yes, from my perspective, why may I get so much love from the people? Just because of the new sensation, the new voice, yeah, everything. You know, so I look my boss, mm-hmm, you see that chop, yeah? Yeah, man, you don't know, new style, new design, new everything.
Yes.
We don't forward with nothing, we're similar. You understand?
Okay.
Yeah, so it's like the people, I'm going to gravitate to something new.
So you're fresh in terms of voice and physical image to yourself?
Yeah, and lyrics, them are shot.
And lyrics are shot?
Yeah, the people, them are relate.
Same.
Yeah, I'm going to feel great, you know?
Okay, and where are you heading?
You know, right now, as we are say, at the Billboard, the Grammy, all of that, we come to achieve everything out of music because that's the aim. Mm-hmm. You understand? Them say Sunfest this year, from long time, artists, a long time, I sit down and wait and I say, all right, my day go.
So you're there already booked and confirmed for Sunfest?
Yeah, man, One King Dance, all about this thing go there on Sunfest.
Wow.
Yeah,
whole so the whole of the West have come for you?
Whole like garrison them. Mm. This year are the most garrison I go there at Sunfest.
Wow.
Yes, man. And the youth take us that, One King.
Are you able to make them, those of them who are having differences with others, behave themselves? Can you talk to them?
Yes.
Do you try to speak to them?
That's one of the main things that me have so much fun because I'm not pick side.
Saying?
Yes. For saying that we don't say over here, so we don't say over this, so we say everybody. Mm-hmm. You understand? When we are singing, we sang them, everybody are related. We don't have an enemy in the street.
So you want unity?
Yes, that's what I'm looking for.
You're calling for that?
That's what I'm calling for.
You're writing lyrics about that?
Of course. That's why the people them say I'm the king.
Yes.
Yeah, because I'm trying to make a change. You understand? Yeah, them don't say, them class we have this, them class we have that, but we have to show them what we can do.
Okay.
Because by the end of the day, people will always talk. We have just got to prove to them what we can do.
Well, my youth, there's no question about you having their ears right now.
Yeah.
You have the full attention of not just Montego Bay and Western Jamaica. You have the attention of Jamaica, all of Jamaica and the world right now, the dancehall space, certainly. Yes. So if you don't take this opportunity to do your best, especially to change mindsets and certain vibes in your city, my friend, it will be a lost cause. Because you have their attention. Use it well and change minds and save lives.
True.
Saying?
True.
Transcend some youth out of this existence into a future existence.
Yeah.
And, you know, put them from where they are now to a better place. You can do it.
Yeah, because
I believe you can, and you believe too, don't you?
Yes, because the music spread the message, you know.
Because if you're a king, you know, you have to behave like you're a king, you
yes,
know.
Yes, I mean, I assure you, the music spreads the message. The music says it all, you understand? And the people, the message them go with. Remember, you know, me, they be advise my song, them, I put out my hard work, them, and them reach a town.
Same.
Me never did after the a town at the time. The ears of the community, them, the younger youth, them, the elder, them take on to the music and say, all right, them like that song, them don't know who sing the song.
Yes, but they them just, like, they like
yeah,
it, yeah.
That the messenger, them same. Want, you understand? So that bring me right here, so right now, and me I tell them to just expect greater things and more hit songs, because that's how we do, make it. You understand?
You sound good, youth. But I should ask you though, first of all, do you have family? Do you have a family yet, your own?
Yeah.
You have kids
yes.
already?
Yes, man, you don't know.
You're 24 now, aren't you?
Yes, I'm 24 August okay. forward in right now. Big up Markima Smith, that's my daughter. You don't know, I have a little young lion of forward right, you know. Big up my baby mother, said we.
Okay.
Same baby mother, you don't know nothing to change. Big up my baby mother, Kayla. Yeah, that. One king dancer about this thing.
With all right, girl, nice. Man. So, one more question.
Yeah.
What do you want for Montego Bay, in your mind? What do you want to see happen to second city Montego Bay? This the
realization.
Vibe city, we call it.
Realization. When we say realization, we mean with everything. Because sometimes we're just living, not realizing what we're doing.
Yes.
You understand? I want everybody in Mobile to just come to the realization that a we can make the change. The change can make without we, so we don't need for ball for help. We don't need state of emergency, and we don't need nobody, we need self. And we alone can say, yo, this can do. And it cannot happen if we say it. You understand? So that's about this thing, I make the people them know, say just make a change. For us and for the people them, we say, maybe you need for change. You understand? Because we really get a fight as artists forwarding from Mobile. Not to depict anyone special, but I'm just talking.
Yes.
Yeah. Just by how me look them say. No. Are the artist is, no oh, man, this not like an artist, man. The artist looks so rugged and rough. You know?
Yeah.
Yeah. But yet still, I'm missing how me grow and I'm missing how them teach me learn.
Well, my brethren, yeah. I want you to shatter.
Yeah.
To totally obliterate
yeah.
that stigma about yeah. Westman or Montegonia.
Yeah.
Because Montego Bay has brought forward some of the most talented people in this country.
Yes, man.
And Mobile is no less. The people in the West aren't any less than the rest of us. In terms of talent, in terms of education, in terms of human being, human rights, love, whatever. You've got it all down there. So, you, as I said before, you have it right. Don't lose it.
Yeah, man.
Bring the talk to reality, as you say, realize.
Realization,
right.
Yes, man.
I like your talk, you.
Yeah, man.
Walk forward, and let's talk again soon.
Yes, man, I don't know. Look for Sif One King forward back in our place anytime soon, man. Tell the people them for us, check out the fan love, because we have a lot of things afford for them, you know.
Yes.
Yeah, man, the Vivo page, subscribe, One King Dancer about this thing. I don't know. If you want forward, you can get any form a link to Ragging King. I don't know, ragingking@gmail.com. Check the Facebook page of Ragging King Sedway. You understand? Instagram, Ragging King Sedway. Yeah.
All right, there you have it. The explosive rise of Ragging King. And once again, we'd like to wish him a speedy recovery and condolences to the family of the young lady who passed. Winfred Williams, on behalf of all of us, thanking you for joining us. Do join us again next week for more. On stage.
No, I hear me experience a lot along the way. I'm here far away to go. Enough never get to see us. Oh, we got my friend, them were dead. Yeah, we knew about pain. I'm in a boss, I got a lot of new home again.
Sunfish,
take time, shot. But not just stop the thing. Rough cut, one jump for me. Yeah, I said it, King Tom. Ice and chains are come. The vibes right and the dogs them five on the dog. Fought in a white and every girl a ball out. If any time with me.
Thanks for watching our video. Please click subscribe and be on our stage anywhere, anytime, always.